The race for Amazon's second headquarters is heating up. Our Scott Cohn is in Annapolis, Maryland, with the governor of one of the cities on the shortlist, Maryland Governor Larry Hogan. Scott.
Thanks. Good morning. There are three sites in metropolitan Washington, D.C. on that list of 20 finalists for Amazon's HQ2, one of them Montgomery County, Maryland. Governor Larry Hogan, you've proposed a package just this week of $5 billion in incentives to lure Amazon. A lot of the other finalists haven't said what they're offering, $7 billion from New Jersey. Is that what you think it's going to take to bring them here?
Well, look, if this is the largest economic development opportunity in a generation, 50,000 jobs, it could have a tremendous impact on our, not just Montgomery County, but our state and the entire region. And, you know, it's something that we believe we're going to do everything possible to try to lure those jobs. These are 50,000 jobs that average $100,000 in salary. So the impact is pretty fantastic. And, you know, some of this is tax incentives over a 15-year period. Some of it is direct money from the state. And a lot of it is infrastructure improvements that will not only help Amazon, but will help the state and the region.
You're a state that's not without needs like any other state. A lot of urban areas, infrastructure issues you just talked about, schools, pension liabilities. Is this the best use of your taxpayers' money?
Well, on the taxpayers' money side, it's about $10 million a year over 15 years. $3 billion of this is Amazon's money that we let them keep in their pocket over 15 years. So it's money we're not currently getting. And the rest of it is infrastructure improvements. And we've got about almost $15 billion worth of infrastructure road projects happening. We're putting $5 billion into a light rail project, the Purple Line, which runs through Montgomery County. So you add it all up, there are a lot more dollars involved. But, you know, we're fully funding our schools, record funding every year. And our budget is our economy is doing very well. CNBC says we have the seventh best overall economic performance of any of the states in the country. So. Mm-hmm.
So why Montgomery County in particular, both over the other two sites, Northern Virginia, D.C., the other 20, why is it important for Maryland to have Amazon here, and why is it a good idea for Amazon to come here?
Well, great. You know, first of all, it's great. I'm excited that there are three potential sites in the Washington area. I think that says a lot out of the 20 that we have three. And anywhere they decided to go would be good for Maryland, because even if it's in D.C. or Virginia, many of those folks are going to live in Maryland. But we're fighting to try to bring it into our state. We believe we have a good shot and a good story to tell. You know, we're located right in the heart of the Mid-Atlantic region. We've got the most educated workforce in America. We were called the most innovative state in the country. We put tons of money into infrastructure. And we have the highest median household income in America. We've had our best year for business in 15 years, our best year for job growth in a decade. We've had one of the best economic turnarounds in America. And we think that this would be just a tremendous shot in the arm for the entire region.
So we've been looking at the various cities involved in this and putting our own numbers to it, top states for business numbers, and doing these report cards. And I want to talk to you about Maryland. We give you a C-minus overall, not bad, but not great. Right. In fact, Northern Virginia does better. The areas where we ding you, yes, you have a great state economy, as you mentioned, but have come under some fire for regulatory issues, need of regulatory reform, so that hurts for stable, business-friendly. Talent, yes, you got a great, strong workforce, educated workforce, but retaining them and attracting people here when there's issues of things like quality of life, crime, air quality, things like that. And then on location, the infrastructure issues, second longest commutes in the country, in this state, and you want to put 50,000 more people here.
Well, wow, that was a lot. That's a lot of issues.
But
Maryland had some real problems. Before I was elected governor, our state economy ranked 49th out of 50 states. Mm-hmm. You now rank us number 7.
Right.
We had tremendous improvements. Some of the things haven't caught up yet. We had self-inflicted wounds. We were overregulated, overtaxed, and we had sort of an anti-business attitude. Mm-hmm. That's all changed. We've eliminated or streamlined 800 regulations. We've cut 255 fees. We've cut taxes 3 years in a row. This will be our fourth year in a row. And that's why we're seeing the best job growth in the Mid-Atlantic region, much better than Virginia. And many of the issues that you're talking about are problems that everybody's grappling with. But Montgomery County, Maryland, is not where you have the crime problem. That was, a difficulty in the Baltimore City's bid. But Montgomery County is one of the wealthiest county in America, a very diverse, very highly educated, and just a tremendous place. I think it fits most of the criteria that Amazon is looking for. We had the second worst traffic in America. We currently have, and nobody had done anything about it for 8 years, I now have $14.7 billion in a transportation plan, $9 billion, 1,000 road projects currently under construction. We just announced the largest public-private partnership in the world, another $9 billion to widen I-270, I-495, Baltimore-Washington Parkway 295. So it's about $27 billion worth of transportation upgrades and a new transit system.
Well, Governor, we wish you well, along with the other 20 cities. We'll see how it goes as our Amazon race coverage continues. Lots more about all of this always at CNBC.com. Carl?
Hey there. Thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.